there was a part about escaping. I just wanted to know more because there are situations, people who you say situations that don't change over years, and that keeps bothering a already unstable mind. So you, there is a tendency that comes avoiding the entire place where any confrontation might happen, and that somehow becomes an escape. That somehow even seems like a beginning of avoiding a situation or avoiding a pain or a pleasure.
Forgetting is not the same as suppressing, is it? You don't meet a person because you have forgotten him, because you see that the meeting is inessential, because you have gone past him. That is one thing. And you do not meet a person because you are deliberately avoiding him. That is another situation. And these are two very different situations. In the first, there is lightness of mind. In the second, you are carrying that person along with you. I'm not against escape, but escape has to be real. Escape has to be complete. We don't completely escape. For us, escape is some kind of physical non-presence. If I'm not meeting you, if I'm not communicating with you, if I'm away from a certain place, if I'm not doing a particular thing, then I say, oh, I have avoided that person, that place, or that activity. You have not really avoided. The avoidance is superficial. Really, the thing is still present with you in the mind. Really, the thing is still dominating you and guiding your actions. What are you saying? I will not go to the place where that person is. Is the thing not dominating you? That thing in the mind is deciding what you are doing. I will not allow such situation to arise. Do you see what you are doing? You are letting that person become even more important to you. You are letting that situation become even more central. Forgetting is a different quality altogether. You have totally forgotten. Now, even if that situation happens, you do not even recognize that it has happened. Because there is nothing left to compare and identify it with. You see, you went to a place and there you got hurt. If you totally forget the hurt, then do you need to avoid that place? Now you can go there again and memories won't even recur. You have forgotten, so there is nothing to bring back the old memory. The old memory got deleted or went deep down into the memory as something useless, as something that must be buried. Now you can go there again. There is no need to avoid. You can be there and later on, when someone comes and reminds you, oh, it was here that that painful incident happened 2 years back, then you may probably remember, oh, was it here? But this place doesn't quite look the same because I am no more the same. Getting it? So, escape totally. And to escape totally is to move into the real. When you move into the real, then you have totally escaped from the unreal. When you are with truth, with silence, then you can easily forget everything else that is rubbish. That is total escape. Total escape is surrender to the truth.
Actually, partial escape seems like a beginning to Masukati, to the mind. It's like if you avoid very forcibly a situation or place, somehow it seems that over time, with no fresh hurt or situation gathered, you'll forget it.
That may or may not happen. If your silent nature takes you away from a place, that is okay. Then that might be the beginning of forgetting. That is possible. That is possible. But even if you have gone away and still you remain tied to the memories, then nothing will happen. When you go away, you must really go away.